Hey guys, in this video we're going to talk about cortisol resistance and insulin resistance. Now you may have heard of insulin resistance, which is a prediabetic state, but you may have not heard of cortisol resistance. So I'm going to kind of explain what it is. They're both a little bit similar in symptoms, but anytime you have a resistance situation, you have a hormone that is not going into the cells properly. In other words, the receptor that's supposed to receive the hormone is resistive, and it's blocking that hormone from going in. So you have a situation where you have a lot of hormone in the body, but you have no effect. It's not creating the function of that hormone. So you can have symptoms of too much of the hormone and a deficiency of the hormone at the same time. So it's very confusing. So let's first talk about the adrenal gland. The adrenal gland is a little, there's two glands on top of the kidney, right down here. And the hormone I'm going to talk about is cortisol. Cortisol is a stress hormone, all right? And what happens is it counters and it deals with stress. When you have stress over a long period of time, the receptor that's supposed to receive that hormone becomes downgraded, or it tends to block that hormone. It's like a protective mechanism. So here are the symptoms first of high cortisol. And this is kind of like a stage one. You have belly fat, okay? You have high blood pressure. You have poor sleep. You have loss of protein, muscle, hair, skin, collagen, joint, disc, bone. A lot of your protein matrix is bone. High cholesterol, low vitamin D levels, acid reflux, even an ulcer. Those are all symptoms of high cortisol. The symptoms of low cortisol are inflammation. So in other words, we need cortisol. You can't live without it, but we don't need too much of it. And cortisol is one of the main anti-inflammatories. So if you don't have this working in the body, you have a lot of inflammation, okay? Itises, bursitis, tendonitis, arthritis, those type of things. Then the immune system is also controlled by the adrenals. The adrenals raise the white blood cell. They help prevent infections. They help you heal with infections. Interesting. So if you're not having that effect, you can have a lot of immune issues. You can be very susceptible to getting colds and viruses and sicknesses. You can develop autoimmune diseases. Okay, so and if you think about it, what do they give people for autoimmune? What do they give people for inflammation? And for like even skin reaction issues, they give them prednisone. What is prednisone? Prednisone is cortisol. It's an adrenal hormone. Allergies, right? A lot of allergy cases, they give you prednisone. Like I had, when I was 28, that was 2 years ago. No, I'm just kidding, I'm 51. But when I was 28, I had really bad poison ivy to the point where I had to have an injection of prednisone. Prednisone is a cortisol, so it helped with the poison ivy. And then, of course, the next year, I get it again. And 5 years in a row, I had to be injected with this cortisone. So that's really one of the things that drove my health going downward. But cortisol is anti-allergic. It also helps asthma, the lung condition. Low cortisol can also create problems with memory issues, dementia, absent-mindedness. You're driving to the street and you're like, okay, where am I going again? And you're constantly in a state of stress because you don't have the hormones to counter stress. So you have a low tolerance, you're impatient, things like that, okay? So with insulin resistance, you can have symptoms of both, and that's why it's really confusing. You get a blood test, and it may show, too much or not enough. It could be subclinical or it doesn't even show up yet because cortisol is on a circadian wave through the day and night. So if they're checking at 8 o'clock in the morning, well, the problem could be at night, so you have to check it every 4 hours, all right? So it's hard to detect this. I like to go by the symptoms. And the treatment or the remedies or the rejuvenation for the adrenal is the same if you have too much or not enough, okay? Except when you get into exercise, okay? But I'm going to create some links down below if you have this, what to do, okay? Now, let's shift over to insulin resistance. This is very interesting because insulin resistance has similar symptoms to the cortisol resistance, okay? Look at high insulin creates, you're thirsty all the time, you're urinating all the time. That's, high insulin is a diabetic state. Dry mouth, belly fat, high blood pressure. See, it's similar. You're inflamed. You have inflammation. You're tired. Like after the Thanksgiving meal, you want to take a nap, right? You're tired after a lunch. You're tired at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. That's an insulin resistance issue, pre-diabetic. And then we have a memory issues. And this can, because there's certain plaquing that occurs in the brain, amyloid plaquing, which is found in Alzheimer's and dementia and even strokes. So, and that's the problem with diabetes. Well, if we go previous to that, that's an insulin resistance situation. And like no one's really fixing the precursor for diabetes. They're actually waiting till you have it, monitoring it, and managing your symptoms, okay? But check this out. The symptoms of low insulin, irritableness, impatient, lightheadedness, sweet cravings, hungry. You can't go a long period of time without being so hungry, headachy, anger, weak, okay? So with insulin resistance, you have symptoms of both high and both low. So what happens is cells don't get the insulin, and one of the purposes of insulin is to drive the nutrition and the fuel in there. So basically your cells are starving, okay, and your brain's starving. So guess what you're going to crave? Sweets. So like your cells can really be deficient in this. So that's why even in diabetic situations, you see that they're the extremities, the feet, they have tingling on the toes, pain in the toes and the fingers. They start getting numbness, eventually gangrene. You lose your eyesight. I mean, you're starving the body of nutrition because we need insulin, but we don't need too much, all right? And I'll create some links down below of what to do with this situation. One last thing, high cortisol can then turn your, and I'm going to create a separate video on this, but high cortisol can turn your body proteins into glucose, which then causes insulin resistance and then diabetes. So this can cause that. So this is all about stress. This is all about sugar, all right? So I guess the motto is avoid stress and sugar. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Please click the share button below and I will see you in the next video.